No pressure, mate, but if you lose this, that could be the making or breaking of our show, right there. Can't come to Kaikoura and go away without a crayfish. Well, I can see some orange. Oh, mate. Now, we've been travelling across the South Island and we've finally arrived at a place I've always wanted to visit. It's the Kaikoura Coast. Of course, it's famous for its whale watching, but it's got big power, crayfish. The trench in here brings all sorts of deep water fish. And then we've got the hills behind us here, which are full of deer and pigs. We're only here for 2 days, so we've got a lot to cram in. Well, here we are, Kaikoura. I'm itching to get out there, but of course, having never ever fished here before, the first thing you do when you arrive at a new area is you hook up with some local knowledge. So my first stop's always the hunting and fishing store. Anton?
Matt, how are you today?
Anton from Kaikoura Hunting and Fishing knows a bit of what goes on out here, and he's teed up for us a local, or well, former commercial fisherman, is that right?
Yeah, former ex-cray fisherman, yeah.
Okay, so he knows his way around the coast?
Definitely.
But there's a couple of rules with fishing with Lester, I believe it is?
He's not going to talk to us today, and we're not allowed to film the sounder.
Okay, so quite a typical cagey commercial fisherman. So what I thought I'd do, to show a bit of solidarity with my commercial fishing brothers and some of my own commercial fishing heritage, I've worn my white boots. And that could probably be a bit of a hunting and fishing tackle tip. If ever you're arriving in coastal or regional New Zealand, get some white barter boots. If there's a freezing works in town or any commercial fisherman, you're going to blend right in and you're going to have instant credibility. Well, Anton here, judging by the amount of lead that he's got there, we know that it's very deep, in fact over 300 metres deep. He's got three squid baits on, pretty hard bait to beat for deep water, but I'm going with a Lacanus, a lure in this depth of water. Remains to be seen how well it's going to go. And Brent over here, he's going to try a jig. Okay, there you go. Don't strike him, mate. Yeah, you got him. You got him? You got him on, Anton?
Yeah,
he's on. Can hear that, the old Shimano Dendamaru winching away there. It hardly seems fair that the biggest fella gets the electric reel. Well, judging by the bend in Anton's rod, there's obviously some decent fish down there. So I'm quite excited about the prospect of making it to the bottom with my Lacanus, if it can make it to the bottom, to see if anything down there is going to eat it. Still kicking, might be his lanos. They seem to fight the whole way up. So, looks like I might be getting a bit of a line angle, might be floating.
25 metres.
Might be the one, mate.
He's 25 minutes, 25 metres, 20 metres.
And the bird's going to bite your line off. What have we got? We've got some colour.
Here it is,
here it is. That's a blue nose. Nose. You beauty. Oh, there's some great eating in that one, mate. That'll come out of a circle hook, so we'll just about lift that straight in. Mate! Hey, and who say they don't have any decent fish in the South Island? Wash your mouth out, please. Well done, mate. That's good chewing, that, the old blue nose.
You can't see these
there. No? Oh, look at these. They're going nuts. They're almost like spinner dolphins. To your left, Dave, is where a group of them are about to jump right there. Like that, mate. See? Preempt it. You've got to preempt the jump. Oh, these ones are going to jump straight out the back. See? Right there. See that? How do I know that, Dave? Ask me, how do I know that? I just do. I just do, mate. I just do. Now, you watch the porting up speed. There's going to be some jump straight out the back of us again in a sec. Like that, mate. See? That's what a whole lot of people come to Kaikoura for, of course, to see the dolphins and whales, and that's because we've got this Kaikoura trench here, which is bringing all this nutrients. You're going to need a lot of nutrients to support that number of dolphins. Okay, well this time I'm going for a soft plastic, and I've got a 4 ounce weight, which is painted Lumo. I've got a squid lure, and I've got some of our Squidgies S-Factor attack trigger. So if the action of that squid sort of enticingly waving around down there isn't enough, we've got a little bit of taste just to put on there as well. Oh, it's got a...
Good bites. Yeah, we're hooked.
You got something on there? Oh yeah, Anton's in. You got something on there? Blue cod on a jig, eh?
Yeah.
Brilliant.
I've got a small blue cod as well.
Oh, another blue cod there as well. There you go. Geez, that's a nice cod, mate. See, now that other one down there, that's what we'd use for live baits for puka. Little perch. Look at that cheeky hua, eh? Blue cod, voracious feeders. We've just moved up a little bit shallower, just so we can get some of our lures to the bottom. And as soon as we've hit the shallows, we've hit blue cod, which isn't a bad thing at all. They are fine tasting fish. In fact, as far as battered goes, the old Fog Dog beer batter on some blue cod is as good as it gets. And then we can go back. However, we'll be keeping that one there.
That one'll be alright.
Yeah. This is probably one of the few places in the world at this time of the year where you don't need to put your fish on ice because it's freezing. There's plenty of ice there. No pressure, mate, but if you lose this, that could be the making or breaking of our show, right there. Can't come to Kaikoura and go away without a crayfish. Well, I can see some orange. Oh, mate.
Well, I hope you're enjoying this classic episode, but if you'd like to see our latest content, action, tips and how-to videos, you can get it all on the Ultimate Fishing app, available now at the App Store, Google Play, or by visiting ultimatefishing.tv.
And that there is your classic single hook pilly rig.
These dolphins, mate. Look at the little hooas. Now, I mean, you look at that braid, like how thin that is. Surely it's near invisible in the water. How those dolphins don't hit it when they're swarming all around here is amazing. Just their sonar, they can ping, it's that sensitive. Their sonar will pick that up and they'll just easily avoid it. Never tire of seeing the old mates, the dolphins. These ones are dusky dolphins, which we don't see a lot up north. And with the backdrop, look at these, are the Kaikoura Rangers. I'm pulling in a few fish for a feed. I mean, mate, what's not to love about visiting new parts of New Zealand? Look at this! Oh, there he goes. Mate, how good is this? Little buggers are hitting it. Not quite big enough. Oh! Another cod, maybe. Whacked my soft plastic. Heavy duty soft plastic at that. Because, of course, a nice groper or a big trumpeter or something could come along. And I always like to fish for the biggest fish I might catch, not the average size one. Well, if this is a cod, I'd say it's a keeper. I'm not a cod fisherman though. I mean, you guys tell me, you should be able to just have a cursory glance at my rod tip and tell me the exact size of this cod that I've got on. being you know, locals and all.
Yeah, that's a good blue cod, mate. You might be in the money there.
Yeah. If it is a blue cod, I'd say it'll be a nice one. But then again, I'm just a tatty old snapper fisherman from up north. We'll have to find out what it is very shortly. Oh, it's a barracuda! Wow. So this is like a, this would be a Kaikoura game fish then, like a Kaikoura kingy, they call them down here. The slabs off of that, those long shiny flanks just make superb baits. And hopefully he hasn't made too much of a mess in my soft plastic, and we can turn him into a few puka very shortly.
Great bait this. Good for puka.
Yeah, no, that's bloody mighty baits.
We have some luck here.
So those baits that you're putting on there, Brent, like you got nice long, flappy, fresh baits, so they sort of wave around in the current a little bit.
Can't miss.
You can't miss.
Awesome.
Yeah. I see you didn't last terribly long on your jig. See Anton's bait's working. Well, I've come back to my Lacanus because we're a little bit shallower now. I see the South Island boys have gone old school, tried and true baits, but I'm determined to show them that you can catch all of these species, blue nose, harp hooker, trumpeter, everything is predatory and you will catch them on lures. Hopefully I do catch something so I can actually show them firsthand. They're right there, let him eat it, and yeah, that's one. Make him pay for it. There you go. Atta boy. See again, now that was on the Barracuda Bay, wasn't it? Yeah, which was caught on a lure, so technically another lure caught fish. Still got him? He's got him there. You go, you good boy. Oh, nice. Good stuff. That's a beautiful set you got there, mate. Beautiful. No pressure, mate, but if you lose this, that could be the making or breaking of our show, right there. That technically lure caught fish you've got on there. Here we go. Nice blue nose. Let's check that hook, we haven't got a circle hook this time, have we? Better make sure I don't bloody bugger this up. There we go, we got him. Well, there you go. I think Anton no longer the biggest blue nose. That's a bloomin' nicey. That's just a good eater. And look how solid these things are through the shoulder. Hey, they're just the meanest looking fish. Blue nose. They get this blue tinge around their nose. Surprise, surprise, someone came up with the name blue nose for him. And he's been taken on a nice fresh slab of that barracuda. Nice fish here, mate. I'm taking, not me, take the glory for your fish. They're covered in the slime, so you're going to get covered in slime. Now, the reason they've got that slime on them, it's actually a cover that protects them from all the bacteria that's in the ocean. It's all fish have it, but the deeper a fish lives, the more of them they have it. And it's almost like snot, the slime that protects them from all the parasites and stuff that would otherwise be clinging to them and sucking the blood out of them. So all of the slime that they excrete keeps them nice and clean. They've got that big mouth that can go around chomping up stuff. They've got these rows of almost blade-like teeth, little needle teeth. Now, they're primarily a squid eater, but they will eat just about anything that comes into their path. And today, it was a slab of the old fresh barracuda. Well done. Great eating fish. Now, of course, I couldn't come to Kaikoura without having a cray dive. So when I hit up Anton and said, what's the cray diving like? He said, it's brilliant. But he was a little bit concerned, being the middle of winter and all, about the swell and the water visibility. So you've chucked out a pot, Anton?
We'll have a look, shall we?
Okay, now when you're potting around here, what are the sorts of things you look for? Places to put
just
your cray
foul. Foul, foul and shallow ground.
Foul, shallow ground. How deep are we here?
About 30 feet.
30 feet, 10 metres. There you go. Well, let's haul it in and we'll see if it's got any crays in it. You all right, mate? Well, I can see some orange. Well, oh, well, that's the colour of the cray pot. Oh, there's one there at least. Oh, mate. Crayfish. One, two, three, four crays. One of those might need a little bit of a measure. This one here is definitely legal. Look at that. This crayfish here, that's got to go back for starters because it's in berry, which is a colloquial term for it's got eggs on it. So we want it to be able to go and lay those eggs to turn into a lot smaller crayfish. So that one's got to go back. Now, this one here looks as though it's legal and it is also in berry. So that one will also be going back. We might be leaving Kaikoura yet without a crayfish. That one there is not in berry, however, is it big enough?
Size buck, it will be.
It will be, yep. We'll measure that one. So the calipers, if it can fit in that hole, it's too small. As you can see, it can't fit in that hole. It's legal. Can't come to Kaikoura and go away without a crayfish. Today, we've come to another stunning part of the Kaikoura coast, and if this doesn't look most like a fishing area, that's because there's a bit of swell running today, so we've come up into the hills. I've got Anton here to show me around because I wouldn't know the first thing about where to find a pig or a deer, but there's a few running around here, mate.
Well, there's lots of pigs and deer around here, and we've got the boys with the dogs, so I'd say we should have a good day, mate.
Yep, well, there you go. Mate, you've got the coast here, you've got the mountains. What more could a bloke want? Let's get into it, eh? mean, one of the things I love about this country is that if you can't get out on the sea to harvest a bit of food, you can come to stunning places like this in the hills.
This is beautiful. Beautiful.
A little bit of a obstacle in the road, a bit of a slip coming out of the bank here. What do you reckon about this one here, mate? Yeah, Anton. Anton's probably got the body weight.
Oh, mate.
We're just pruning the tree as well.
As we make our way deep into the Kaikoura Ranges, we're on the lookout for red deer up in the hilltops. But I'm so taken by the scenery all around me that we drive right past two stags. But Anton, in his trained eye, sees them moving off for cover. So he whistles to get their attention. Whistling is a last resort tactic. It will often make the deer stop momentarily to see where the noise is coming from. But just a second before Anton was set to take a shot, the deer broke for cover. So from here, we'll be a bit more quiet and going on foot.
Well, we're just gonna work our way away from the bikes. Up this track, we've got the dogs, which are trying to pick up scent of wild boars. And Anton has got his rifle because the stags that he spotted a moment ago came up and over that ridge. So boar hunting and a semi deer stalking. Yep, we're on, bro. Yeah, squealing. There we go. Little wee boar, which dogs did a good job to find, not too far up the track. Jeez, he's a fat little pig, isn't he? Good size to carry too. Might even look like a real boar on my back. Won't put it on Anton's. It'll look like a rabbit on Anton's back. Might be a pig up there, the dogs. Looking keen. Yeah, got one. He's got one. Oh, he's bailing. Bailing. The pig's broken. Hopefully, well, what's happened is the old main dog, the older dog, Bond, found a pig, grabbed it, it had squealed. The pig's broken. And we're hoping the second dog, the younger dog, Johnny, gets here and they can bail it. Dogs are fitter than us. Hey Dave. It's scoffing. Yeah, it's scoffing. Bit of a punch up happening.
There it is.
This one sounds a little bit bigger. I got it about a minute. Oh yeah, here he is. The dogs will struggle to hold it in tight spots like that. See the dogs working to cut it off. The pig. Oh, it's broken away. It's going downhill. More running. Oh, okay, here we go, Dave. There's a pig in there. You want some spiky there for you too, mate? Few spikes there, bro.
Yeah,
bloody pig keeps breaking. Sometimes it's easier just to crawl your way through, just like a pig would, through these sharp thorns. It's blue ball. We've got a new holder in the pack. His name is Brent.
I want to do the deed, mate.
Oh, okay. Oh, have you got... He's buggered. It's all over for that pig now. And, well, some people might find that hard to watch, which is understandable. That pig has lived a wild and free life in a beautiful place like this. It wasn't raised in a sow stock crate. And it wasn't lined up with its mates to be slaughtered so people could buy it in nice vacuum pack packages. And none of that meat will be wasted. And the dogs did extremely well. Good dogs.
There's still plenty more to come as we finish our hunt up in the hills and make our way back to the coast for a dive before heading out for some big midwinter kingfish.
Yep, hit it. Got them on.
Yeah.
No kingfish in the South Island, what?
We hope you enjoyed this classic episode, but if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.